philosophy function we were given in terms of t and uppercase t. Some of the critical parts of this function we were given is negative t and t that tells us something about the position graph, where the helicopter lands and where it takes off from and where it lands finally. So initial, launch, and final land. Critical points are when this derivative of position, when that equals zero, which indicates the position graph behavior. So that would be
of the helicopter starts. And so first I'm plugging in negative t into t, putting that in the equation. Now that we've finished writing out the acceleration equation, if t equals negative t, now we are going to focus on inputting t equals zero into the acceleration, and so we can see if the motion of the helicopter will keep going in the same direction or turn. Now that we have finished inputting the two chosen values, we can conclude that the motion of the helicopter does travel in a negative direction and a positive direction, meaning in terms of displacement from the origin, the motion would be going forward first, stopping at some point, and then going towards the negative direction till, of course, it lands on the ground. This supports that we can say that in some point of the flight, the helicopter must have changed directions.
If we evaluate r of t at the initial and final times, we can get the initial and final position. From this over here, we have t negative and t positive. So change in t is going to be t final, positive capital T, minus t initial, which is negative capital T. So change in t is actually just 2t. Our distance equation makes sense. D equals 2 over 3 beta t squared, because when you derive for change in x, you get x final minus x initial, but since x initial, if you factor out that negative, it's just negative. So x final minus negative initial is just 2 times that x, which gives you distance. So distance equals 2/3 beta t squared. First, we made the assumption that. So we've made sense of the position, velocity, and the acceleration graphs, but we still don't know what beta is, and we don't know what acceleration. We don't know what beta is, and we don't know what alpha is either. And one way we can deal with that is by checking units. So using sense making with units, we can use the r of x, we can use the position function x component and the position function y component to check what alpha and beta are. So if you simplify each of these, you should get distance in meters equals whatever beta is times seconds over seconds, so that's seconds cubed over seconds squared, gives you seconds squared plus seconds squared, which is just seconds squared, which means that beta has the units of meters per second squared, which is an acceleration. Same with position y component, you just have meters equals whatever alpha is, have seconds squared minus seconds squared gives you just seconds squared. So alpha also is the acceleration because it's in meters per second squared. So alpha and beta are constants of acceleration.
Alright, so in this reflection, I'm going to be discussing how various problems we've solved in homework, in studio, in lecture, and on the first quiz all provided different problem-solving strategies and elements that we would ultimately use to discuss the problem in this project. It used elements like projectile motion, motion graphs and diagrams, acceleration and position graphs, and sense-making strategies that would all help in solving this problem. This first problem was simple, but it's an example of a problem that would be helpful towards uncovering what the final position graph of the helicopter would look like. This problem presents the graph of acceleration versus time and asks for the graph of position versus time and velocity versus time. In this project, it's a little different because we were given the equations but not the graphs. So after we found the graph for the position function, finding the integral and derivative graphs were easier. This problem was similar, and it's another example of working with position graphs to uncover more about the problem. For example, in this one, we have to draw a motion diagram and then draw position versus time graphs, and both of these things would end up helping us solve the problem in the end. So we would use similar steps and strategies to uncover more about the helicopter problem in the project. Sense-making strategies are also very important in this project. Like it says in this problem, solving problems symbolically is crucial to completely understanding it. Additionally, understanding key expressions and concepts that were used is also important. And finally, one of the main steps in our process in this project was checking the units and making sure they made complete sense relative to the problem we were solving.
So something we did differently in this project is we were given the solutions and having to find it. So that was definitely something that we haven't done before. It was a good exercise. It helped us really focus on analyzing the pieces of the problem instead of trying to see it as a whole and then breaking it down from there. Another unique part of this problem was that we're focusing on something that does have propellers and does have the ability to change motion. So unlike treating it as, unlike a soccer ball problem where you kick a ball and it just has projectile motion, this instead can change direction and can change its magnitude. So that concludes our video. Hope you liked it. I hope you learned something and hopefully you didn't fall asleep.